In other news, he may just about have only started swimming lessons this year, but our very own Thomas Little is about to attempt a world-first marathon across one of the most... Yes, that's him. He can swim a little bit. Treacherous bodies of water in the world. He and a team headed up by Aussie long-distance legend Chloe McArdle will do a relay from England, all to raise money to find a cure for spinal cord injuries. So, for one last time, before we lose him to the North Sea, he joins us now from London. Would you please welcome Thomas Little?
Hello, gang.
Thomas, most important question, are you going to make it to Belgium?
I honestly, Haim, have no idea. I just checked the water temperature and it's a touch under 10 degrees Celsius, which, for those who don't know, if you jump in that water and you haven't been training for it, after about 30 minutes, you won't be able to speak anymore, your voice goes kind of slurred, you sound a bit drunk, and then after about 45, hypothermia's kicked in and you might die. And that's led me to the question, what do I do to people's donations if I don't make it? If I die, do I have to refund people's donations to the swim?
OK, but seriously, Tommy, how is this actually going to work? Because it is a very, very long way. So what are the logistics of this swim?
It is a very long way. It's 92 kilometres. And the sad answer to your question, Tony, is because this swim has never been done before, we kind of don't know how it's going to work. The Belgian authorities are very confused that there's going to be a bunch of swimmers arriving on their shore. Technically, there is eight of us in the team, right? And we take it an hour at a time, which is just enough time. But like I said, hypothermia to fully kick in and then just enough time to recover before you have to get in and do it again. And I'm going to be doing those hour swims maybe seven, possibly eight times, because once again, depending on the swells, depending on the weather we get, we just don't know how long it's going to take. 50 hours is what we've kind of banked on.
Tommy, you're a brave soldier, but what are you most afraid of?
Hopefully, you know I'm not brave, so thank you. I'm afraid of everything. Seaweed still touches my leg and it scares me. But I think if I'm being 100% 100% honest, the thing that I'm most scared of is getting seasick.
Yes.
The North Sea, the swells are a lot bigger than in the English Channel, and I'm worried that I'm going to get out there, get seasick, and then once you get seasick, you kind of can't get better, and I think spending 50 hours of spewing and the only reprieve that I get from spewing is to get in the water and swim while spewing, that sounds like worse than anything the ocean has to offer.
I don't want to get serious about this, but the last time I went for a swim with you, you didn't even own Speedos, which I think is a real red flag as far as this whole thing is concerned. Like, can you actually
yes.
swim now?
But since then, I've been swimming every day. It helps that my coach is the best endurance swimmer in the world, Chloe McArdle. And I don't want to brag too much, Haim, but at the end of our cold water swim camp the other week, one of the guys said to me at the end, "Congratulations, you're no longer just a teabagger." Now, I thought that was a filthy expression, but it turns out teabaggers is what they call people that just, like, float in the water like a teabag. Haim, do you want to see... I never thought I would ask this, but do you want to see my... Because I didn't have the crutch confidence... I'll just say, I didn't have the cock confidence to wear Speedos in public. But now, I've been wearing Speedos non-stop, even when I'm not swimming. Do you want to see my Speedo tan?
Yes.
Sure, let's do it.
I think... I don't know if I can actually show you this. It's so
definitely
wild. So that's
cut.
My... That's my... Look at that. Look at that. I wonder if I can get my whole... I want to see the show below. Look at that.
Kim
Kardashian, yeah. Eat your heart out on that one.
Now, this is going to be some segue, Tommy, but you are raising money for a really great cause to find a cure for spinal injuries. So what is the target and where are you currently sitting with it?
It is a fantastic cause. It's to raise money for hopefully a groundbreaking trial to find a cure for something that at the moment doesn't have one. I'm aiming to raise $100,000. At the moment, we are just shy of $40,000, which is why I've decided to put my money where my mouth is. And for the next 24 hours, I will match anyone's donations up to $10,000. So if you want to get involved, just search Tommy Little's Big Swim. It's also on my Instagram. And, I will, like I said, open my wallet because it's something I really believe in and hope we find a cure for very soon.
And stop pulling
and
your pants down.
And now here's my ass again.
Stop pulling your pants down. And stop. Just stop. I'll pay you to stop. You can still donate to Tommy's fundraiser or just give him money to stop pulling his pants down. Head to Tommy's Instagram right now to donate. Tommy, good luck. We'll see you on the other side.
Love you guys.